let's take a look at how you take a screenshot with Jing. So suppose you've got some image on the computer that you'd like to take a snapshot of, say some picture in OneNote or PowerPoint or whatever. Go up to the Jing Sun and select the crosshairs to pick an image that you'd want. And you can pick an entire window or maybe just a region. So the minute you've grabbed a region, push the button that looks like a Polaroid picture. Jing will then show you the image that you've just taken right here. Now you notice that there's some buttons on the side over here. These allow you to do annotations. For example, you can do arrows or write text or draw boxes. And they're really easy to use. Just select the thing you'd like an arrowhead, pick a color, say red, and then draw it by just dragging points around. So boom, you could point at a picture here. If you wanted to add some text to make it more clear, you can also select a text cell, draw the rectangle first, and then type in whatever you'd like to do. It's really easy. If you don't like the movement of stuff, you can move them and drag them around. It's designed to be very, very user intuitive. The next thing is you're going to get the name. The name is always some big, horrible jumble of numbers. It's a date stamp. And if you want to, you can rename this something more useful, Cow or Bobby or, say, Whiteboard, since that's what this program is right here. And then once you've got it named, you can go and save it or share it. You can share it to screencast, which means you can put it online for other people to use with a URL. You can save it to a folder as a PNG file, or you can copy it to the clipboard, and then you can then run into another program and paste it by hitting Control-V or right-click paste. And that's actually a pretty useful way of dropping pictures into a Word document or, say, into a dyno panel. And that's the basics of picture taking.